Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be comparing a microwave cookie with a baked cookie. Now the recipe is going to be exactly the same and it's very very simple, and I wanted to see what would be difference, because the recipe is so simple and it's mentioned the recipe that you can either put it in the microwave for 2 minutes or you can bake it. So what would be the exact difference, like would there be difference in the texture, the taste, what is going to be it? And I really wanted to have some cookies, so why not? So let's get into making cookies. So here is my bowl and I'm ready to make the cookie dough. Let's get it. So the recipe, I have actually doubled the recipe from what it was given in the site. So I have doubled the recipe because I'm going to make 2 batches and then I'm going to divide it and put 1/2 in the microwave and 1/2 in the oven. 4 tablespoons of flour. Then I needed 2 tablespoons of melted butter. So I have melted the butter and the bowl is very hot. Then 2 teaspoons of cocoa powder. I love cocoa powder. Even though it tastes horrible, to be honest, cocoa powder, which because it's not sweetened. But the smell is so good. I don't know how people control themselves by using cocoa powder. So I've added all the ingredients in this bowl. I have not mixed it. It called for 4 tablespoons of flour, 4 tablespoons of granulated sugar, 2 teaspoons of cocoa powder, milk, butter, vanilla essence, baking powder, and I forgot to add. So mix all of this and then I'll divide the batter into 2 and I'm supposed to just make 1 giant one instead of small cookies. That's what the recipe said, so I'm just going to do that. Now my mixing skills are not great because even though I have baked cookies before, I'm not great at it. So if you are, bake a lot of cookies and you're just very angry at seeing my mixing skills, and I'm sorry if you're offended, but I really don't know how to mix properly, but I'm trying my best. So I have the batter right over here. I'm going to divide it. First I'm going to bake it because baking takes more time and it's going to only take around 2 minutes in the microwave. So while the baked one cools, it can just cook in the microwave. Let's do it. Because I cannot find my baking dish, I have to resort to using this. And I've already divided the cookie dough. It's supposed to expand in the dish. Hopefully there's enough space for this cookie to expand. And I'll put it in the oven now. Here's the baked cookie. Now it did not expand much, but it did. And according to the recipe, once it comes out of the microwave, I'm supposed to put in chocolate chips from the top and let it cool down. Now I do not have chocolate chips, but I did cuts up some chocolate and decided to use them as chocolate chips. Now it's not as very hard, it's actually pretty soft, so the cookies are so the chocolate is you can easily put it into the cookie. It's hot. Put in the chocolate chips, basically a chocolate bar cut into really small pieces, but we can say chocolate chips. And I'll let this one cool and I'll wait for the other one to come out of the microwave. My cookie is out of the oven. Now it did not expand as much as I thought it would. And I think it's my fault because I have not added enough baking powder. I should have added more. So I think that is why the cookie has not expanded. And I hope it does not affect the texture or the flavor. I might have burned up the surface up a bit. So it is actually my fault. So there is a lot of my fault in this. I think I've slightly overcooked this one. Burnt outside but still chewy inside. It's still a pass for me and I still love it. So I've put in the chocolate chips. Now if you see carefully, the chocolate chips are not actually as much as, into the cookie as they were with the baked ones, because I have burnt the surface up a bit. And it's my fault because I may have microwaved it for a bit too long. But it's fine, as long as it's even a little burnt on the outside but still chewy on the inside, it's a pass for me. I enjoy it. So I'm going to wait for this to cool, one as well as the baked one is cooling off. And once both of them are nice and chill and I can bite into it, I'm going to try and see, you know, which one's better maybe. Cookies have chilled out completely and I've also made myself a cup of coffee because that's how I actually enjoy my cookies whenever I have any. It's just with a nice cup of coffee. How do you like it? Do you like it with milk? And I've also seen some people have it with like juice, orange juice to be specific. But my coffee and my cookies. Yeah, that's me. Try the baked one first. This is a baked one. Oh, good. It is so good and it's pretty soft. Chocolate's like nice and melted, so amazing. And I'm gonna try the microwave one. Now this one is a slight burnt. The microwave one. Mmm, it's so good. Very good. They, both of them are very good. I think the baked ones are a little less chewier, while chewier, if it's a word, chewier, I don't know. And this one's more chewy, so I prefer the microwave one more than the baked one. Pass it to the microwave one more, while the baked one is actually pretty soft and it's a little bit hard on the outside, that's there, but it's much more softer compared to the microwave one. And it, I think it might also have been my, you know, fault in, you know, microwaving it a bit more, so it's even more harder on the outside. But I still prefer the microwave one. In my opinion, I prefer the microwaved one. But the recipe is actually pretty good, and I think if I wouldn't have made the, you know, small errors that I've made in making it, it would have been even better. But it wouldn't be a cookie made by me if I wouldn't have made any errors. So yeah. So I hope that you enjoyed the video, and I'm gonna put the link for the recipe in the description below. And if you try these, please let me know which one do you like better. Do you like the baked one or the microwave one? And if you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.